viewers. Oh, I bet it's... Three viewers, so it's streaming.
Right, okay. Okay, so 18 viewers. I feel like I'm having a deja vu. Oh. 45 viewers. Right, hopefully they've all gone. I've logged Jamie in, I've changed all my passwords to everything. So, and all the videos have hopefully gone away. And, well, my passwords are changed now anyway, so. And I only used it for that one, so it doesn't really matter. But, and try again, without flapping. Sorry, I was really stressed and that. Right, let's try again, shall we?
Right.
I just realised that PayPal thing would cover in my hand for playing guitar, which would have looked terrible and would have been really annoying, so, yeah. Okay, let's start again. So, yeah, we're going to run later today, so we'll probably be going till 6:30, just because it was just a nightmare. Anyway, happy anniversary to John Atkinson's mum and dad. It is their 75th. No, it isn't. It's their 65th wedding anniversary tomorrow. Right. So, I'm going to play this next one, which is for Dawn Windridge's birthday, which is on Wednesday, and also for Anthony Robin. And this is... I am thrown today now. Nothing else matters. I love the way that Graham Corsley's just put, I'm just joining, so hopefully I haven't missed anything. You've missed, like, the most stressful half hour. Right, well, 20 minutes. Anyway, this is, I think somebody's asked if you can turn subtitles off. I think you just click on
the... You basically click on your Facebook video, click on the little cog, and then you can say turn off the subtitles.
Yeah. Okay, so this is Nothing Else Matters. So close, no matter how far, it couldn't be much more from the heart. Forever trusting who we are, and nothing else matters. I never opened myself this way. Life is ours, we live it our way. All these words I don't just say, and nothing else matters. Trust I seek and I find in you. Every day for us something new. Open mind for a different view, and nothing else matters. I never care for what they do. I never care for what they know. So close, no matter how far, it couldn't be much more. all from the heart. Forever trust in who we are, and nothing else matters. Trust I seek and I find in you. Every day for us something new. Open mind for a different view. And nothing else matters. I never care for what they say. I never care for games they play. Never care for what they do. I never care for what they know. And I know
so just in case anyone is still seeing the captions, to get rid of those on Facebook, just under the stream, there's a little cog gear settings icon. You click on that and then you'll see it's something that says auto-generated captions, and you just turn that to off. Have you ever tried spam? I've just realised I've never actually tried spam.
No, I might have had it as a kid. Is it a bit like corned beef?
Yeah, it looks like it, doesn't
it? It looks like corned beef, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Because I used to love, like, corned beef ash when I were a kid. Did you ever have corned beef ash?
I don't think I have. I used to have corned beef sandwiches.
My mum likes corned beef sandwiches with brown sauce and that Branston's pickle.
Yeah, corned beef. It was like corned beef sandwiches, but on really cheap white bread. I kind of quite like that in a strange way.
I liked crisp sandwiches. Crisp sandwiches was the future. We've started getting a bit of cheese, haven't we? On a Saturday, we do a big walk, it's a 4.5 mile walk into town, and we go to cheese shop.
So basically, because Saturday has become the three C's, coffee, cheese, and
Chinese. Yeah, it's great. Jamie did make a song for that earlier on when he was in the kitchen, but come on, sing is it.
Well, I just have.
That wasn't it, that was talking it. Oh, blimey, car blimey, what a day, eh? So this next one is for Francesca Macchio. I hope I've said that right. This, I'm nudging that, that's where it is. It's annoying me.
Oh, this is going so well. Jamie, can you just come and lift this up?
Because it's all going really wrong.
I need that lifting off the floor. So just hold that.
Well, it's going so well today, isn't it?
I'm trying to move that up because I keep knocking it and it's annoying.
Right, this is for Francesca Macchio. Hopefully I've pronounced that properly. And this is a little Jimi Hendrix song called Voodoo Child.
Thank you.
drop it down with the edge of my hand. Well, I'm standing next to a mountain. I drop it down with the edge of my hand. I'm gonna pick up all the pieces and make an island. Might raise a little sound. Because I'm a voodoo child.
That myth about well, ELP, when they were thinking about having a guitarist, they thought about Hendrix.
No.
In which case, they would have been called Help.
Ah, that's a really good thought.
And the other classic, well, the band that never came to anything was, I think it was in the early 80s, when Robert Plant, Jimmy Page, Chris Squire and Alan White got together, and they did some tapes? some recording, and they were going to call themselves XYZ for X, Yes and Zeppelin.
That's a good idea as well.
Just for people asking about subtitles, sorry to talk subtitles again, but you can actually turn them off on a phone as well, but it's a different way. So if you're on a phone, all you need to go into the top right-hand corner where there's the three dots. So you click on the three dots, and then you'll see a menu that comes up, and then you need to click on closed captions, and then there's an option for turn off captions, and that will do it. So that's how you turn it off on a phone.
Hmm.
So lots of spam fans. People talking about spam fritters.
Oh, actual meaty spam, not
yes, but not spam.
Not silly people that comment on my Facebook and upset me.
Yeah.
I'm in a better mood now. Now I've kind of got over that and changed all my password.
A bit of voodoo child and...
yeah, I took it out on the guitar
a bit. Someone put that the subtitles came out as boo-boo. Boo-boo.
Have you ever watched Sky News' subtitles? If you ever, like, in pub, if they ever... Well, when pubs were a thing, and you could actually go to them. Like, Brighouse Wetherspoons used to have Sky News on with subtitles, and they were so funny, some of the subtitles.
Yeah.
I wonder if it can translate Yorkshire. Maybe.
I think TVs and pubs are just wrong. Like it's like like fruit machines.
We played on a fruit machine.
Oh, apparently, Clive Hughes says the XYZ tapes available on bootleg.
Ooh. Wonder if they're on Spotify. Right, so I'm going to do this next one. I'm going to do that one. Right, so this morning, Country Hits Radio played me playing this song because I sent them a little video earlier in the week. I thought, I'll make a little video, and I did this one. So, yeah, they played it this morning, which was quite nice of them. Sorry, I'm still flustered from that silly spammer. It's like, right, this is Morning Song, and it's also for Paul Snook, and and them at Country It's Radio. So, yeah.
Let the phone ring and let's go back to sleep. Let the world spin outside our door. You're the only one that I want to see. Tell your boss you're sick. Hurry, get back in. I'm getting cold. Get over here, warm my hands up. Boy, it's you they love to hold. And stop thinking about what you're
John Hurd has asked, is there actually a hamster slash gerbil slash mouse in the cage at the back? I never see any movement.
He sleeps in the daytime.
He's a bit shy, isn't he?
He's not shy at night time. He's nocturnal, though. He's nocturnal, so he comes out at night time, and he's called Stevie the hamster, and he's a very friendly soul.
Yeah.
He's friendly, and he's beautiful until the cows come home. This is the little song that we sing to him all the time, and I think he thinks we're a bit nuts. You've got a different version of it, though. You sing a different one.
Oh,
you
yeah,
sing
it's a bit ruder, isn't it?
No, it's not. You sing Stevie
version.
The hamster. He's a very friendly
the
soul.
Version.
He's... What is it you sing?
I can't remember.
You can! Anyway. yes. So, I'm going to do... I'll just mention, because somebody's just mentioned the PayPal link. So it should work. Literally, it's. I want, like, I know for like the first, 40, 50 weeks of lockdown when I did shed sessions, I says, I'm not going to do with PayPal. But then, because we've kind of upgraded all the equipment and we're now paying a subscription thing for streaming onto YouTube and everything. So, because it's costing me now. So I put a PayPal link thing. You don't have to put anything in it. Please don't feel obliged. It's just, you know, if you want to chuck a quid in to grab a coffee with. It'd be lovely, but it's not expected, and you know, certainly don't if you don't need to. So just enjoy the stream.
And obviously, the link is on the main the post, not the little thing there. You if you click on that, it won't do anything. So to go to it, you have to click on the link in the actual.
Didn't think of that.
On the actual message.
Yeah.
The stream, Facebook.
Yeah, it's basically you just type that, or you can just type that into the thing. Anyway,
I've just checked and it works. So
yeah, right.
I've given you some.
You've given me some money.
1p.
1p. Right. So this is a little song that I did. Acoustically, we were doing it with the band a bit and the cajon and stuff before lockdown. And this is off my second album. No, it's not. It's off my first album, and it's called Caught Out. Hey, Mr. Know-it-all, say I'm nothing. Shout your mouth off, you don't know nothing. Straight-laced, two-faced, you can see right through you. Because the masks don't cover up the bad things you do. Yeah, you got caught out, trying to put me down. Don't know how I became a friend to you. Maybe she can't rock like I do. Or is it I don't suck up to you? Well, I don't need leather to make my moves. Yeah, you got caught out trying to put me down. So just to let everybody know, Stevie is a boy. Stevie is a boy, and when we got him, I was like, I don't want a hamster with red eyes. And I was quite like, I want a hamster with long hair, and I want it to have not red eyes and everything. And then I spotted this little Stevie hamster, and it was so cute. And I was like, well, his eyes are slightly red, and he's got short fur, but he's lovely. So Jamie says, well, why? Because the guy in the pet shop said, he might be a little bit visually impaired because he's got like a bit of albino in his eyes. So you said, we'll call him Stevie after Stevie Wonder. Well, no, you said Steve at first. Yeah. I was like, we're not calling the hamster Steve. So
actually, it's funny when people say that like, Stevie is a female name, because when I think of Stevie, the first thing I think of is Stevie Wonder, Stevie Ray Vaughan. I guess there is Stevie Nicks as well. But yeah.
Well, basically we said, because you said Steve, then you said Stevie after Stevie Wonder, and I said, Stevie, after Stevie Nicks, even though he's a boy.
Was that actually, but my name is unisex, isn't it?
Jamie, yeah.
Particularly in America.
It's great, because I ring up for Chinese and say, oh, my name's Jamie.
Yeah.
And then when you go collect it, you say, my name's Jamie, and it's fine. So it works a treat, does that?
So Paul Snook is asking, I wonder what funky shirt Jamie has on tonight. And that's the thing now. I actually have to consider my the dress code now. You know, people want to know. Yeah. I can't just wear a plain T-shirt anymore. Steve Major says, I think we need a Stevie Rocks T-shirt.
Yeah.
Someone else asked, actually, is there going to be a second Shed Session T-shirt as well?
Yes, there will be, with the Shed Session CD, which is nearly finished. So this next one I'm going to do is a little Bonnie Raitt song, and this is called Love Has No Pride. Actually, I'm just going to have a little drink of my Nosecco. This is what I'm on today. What are you all drinking today and eating for tea? We're having Chinese again, because that's our Saturday.
Yeah, I'm having a Heineken Zero.
Heineken Zero alcohol, yeah. And I'm on alcohol-free Nosecco. And I've got a spoon in the top to keep my fizz. I learned that off Facebook. I've been dead posh with my, like, pretend Prosecco.
Mm. It's quite nice, that pretend Prosecco.
It's really nice. Mm. I really like it. The Rosé Freshener is really nice as well. Or the Harvest Potter one, as you call it. So, this is Love Has No Pride.
Give anything to see you again. grace I'd give anything to see you again.
Dino's still got my alcohol-free Radlers that I left in Spain. Because when we got stuck there, we bought like another week's worth of shopping, thinking we were going to be stuck there. And then I managed to get an emergency flight back. And then we didn't need all the shopping, so I gave Dino it all.
And why not?
Oh, I feel much calmer now. After all
don't
that stress.
Let the spammers get you down.
Deary me.
So I ended up, when I was working earlier this week, it was interesting, wasn't it? I told you, I ended up at Sid Barrett's former house. And I didn't know that, but actually it was on, I didn't know it was Sid Barrett's former house, but Google Maps told me, which was quite interesting.
You sent me a WhatsApp and was like, guess where I am?
Yeah.
In capitals, and then sent me a screenshot, and I was like, pretty cool.
You didn't know, so you know how some of those places have like the blue plaque and says so and so wants to live there. It doesn't have any of those. It looks, yeah, you'd never know.
No,
but I don't know. What, you know, yeah, it's on Google Maps though.
Oh, interesting, crazy. So, just let me check whose birthday. I've done that one. So, Simon's birthday is on Friday. That's from Lynn and Michael. And also hi to Lauren from her granddad Tony Mann. I'll do one more acoustic one, and then, if you want to come and play. Right, so, John Atkinson's put, is it Jamie time? Do you not like me, John?
Is it hammer time yet? Is that it's hammer time.
It's hamster time. Hamster time. Speaking of, I'm going to do this one. This one is for Simon's birthday on Friday from Michael and Lynn, because they asked for this one. This is Cat Song.
It reminds me of, it could be like a Corey Wong type song.
Like a really bad version of Corey Wong.
It's good, it's really good.
Like a really non-rhythmic bad version.
That's why I shouted funky. Sorry if that was that ruined your performance, but I feel the need to shout.
You shouted out the word funky! I was like... do you want to come and play some piano? Because John Atkinson likes you better than me. Sorry, John.
This time I'm going to try not to show my backside to everyone. I tell you what I'm going to do.
Did make me laugh last week when somebody says, like your new credit card machine, Jamie's bum. Like Mackenzie on Neighbours. If anybody watches Neighbours, Mackenzie on Neighbours. I don't know why they dress her like that, but somebody put on Facebook the other day, why does she look like she's like an old lady on a cruise? What the dresser is. Jamie's tangled because we've got about 7 billion leads all over the floor. Everything's very tangly because we've got like, literally, I think we've got about 18 leads running everywhere. So everything just gets tangled in everything and we fall over everything. There. Oh, I don't need that. I don't need one. Right. Let's do the tags first. Okay. Yeah, Paul and Miss Jinx. I nearly just called you Stevie then. Jamie wore his t-shirt just for you. Because he was like, Paul always asks what t-shirt I'm wearing, so I'm going to wear this one this week. I was like, oh, okay, cool. And this week as well, we have got a live art group sketching us, or doing however they want to paint us all, in Italy. Life models. We're life models, life drawers. I did a life drawing class on Zoom the other week. That was different. It was very weird. Didn't like it. I switched off halfway through, I think, because it was just like, and my drawing's terrible. So this is called Anaesthetize. And this is for Michael, who is his birthday, from Susan Northern.
Prophesies, Anaesthetize.
sure you'll testify. I will leave you satisfied. Another stranger's lullaby.
Sorry, I forgot to learn that cello bit, didn't I? Yeah. Someone was asking about commenting on my tablet case. Is it new? No, it's just in its upright position.
John Siemens has put, if Chris Whitley and Patty Griffin had a baby, it would be anaesthetised. I love Chris Whitley.
I don't know who that is.
I don't think I've put Chris Whitley on for you. I don't know if it'd be your thing. It's kind of like just amazing. It's like country bluesy. I'm gonna meet you in the big sky country. It's just like so good. I might have to put it
on the farm, man.
Yeah. So, because I listen to Country Hits Radio like constantly, it's either Stephen Wilson or Country Hits Radio or an 80s playlist on Spotify at the moment. So, Jamie calls it my flippy floppy music, don't you? So I've got the country stuff, and he goes, working on the farm and a flippy floppy flu. But anyway, shall we do Angel?
Please.
So this week we have painted the kitchen. We did one wall of it a few weeks ago and then thought, should we just do the whole thing? So we've painted the whole kitchen blue. And I was like, because you wanted to get new cupboards, and I was like, why don't we just like paint them?
Well, the kitchen no longer looks like a squat now, because it did for years, because I'd gone mad with the tester pots and written some rude words on the wall, hadn't I?
And I painted a flower over them. And yeah, so we decided to paint it and make it look like an actual adult kitchen rather than a squat.
Adult kitchen sounds a bit dodgy as well.
So yeah, we painted the cupboards and then realised that I'd painted it in matte furniture paint and you don't like the matte paint. So then we tried to get a gloss from B&Q to paint over it to make it shiny, like shiny cupboards. And apparently you can't do that. Don't work, apparently, so we still have matte cupboards. But anyway. And we bought a spice rack. That was exciting. It's been a very exciting week. Right, this one is for Dave Mason, and this is Angel. You are poor.
so tired of this straight line, and everywhere you turn, there's vultures and thieves at your back. The storm keeps on twisting, and keep on building the lies that you make up for all that you lack. It don't make no difference. Escaping one last time, it's easier to believe that in this sweet madness, oh, this glorious sadness that brings me to my knees, you're in the arms of
something halfway through it, and I thought, oh, I must answer that, and then I forgot what it is. Oh, about country. Do I know any Miranda Lambert? I don't, but I really love her new song. The one that's like, I might get the other way. That one.
That sounds like, I want to be a hippie. That song, do you remember that? I want to be a hippie.
I do remember that song. No, it's the new Miranda Lambert song. I really like it. It's great. And also, Amanda Jane Caunter just put that she really likes Brothers Osborne and Cadillac Free.
Brothers Johnson.
I'm really into them as well. I think they're great. I like you like Brothers Johnson, anyway.
Very different.
Very different. Very, very different. Shall we do... what should we do? Should we do I'm No Good For You? Good for the price.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Jamie calls it Good for the Price. Yeah, So. So we're going to play this one. This one's off my first album. I had to think about that then. This is I'm No Good For You. Still reminds me of True Blood, Peter Corkaput, and it probably reminds you of True Blood because that's what I wrote it about. True Blood's a really good vampire telly program. I was obsessed with it. Like, literally, all I would talk about and watch is True Blood. I was like, Bill! I actually have started watching it on your Skybox. Well, I won't be watching it anymore because Skybox broke last night. Jamie was like, I'm going to get rid of Sky tomorrow. Dee, 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 dee. Happy birthday to Ryan Bywater from Vicky and Malk. And she put, please keep going with these sets, they keep us sane, which we will be doing until lockdown lifts and we can gig again. We'll be still doing these little shed sessions, won't we? The little shed. Oh, it's that side, isn't it? The one behind my head. There is a shed, and there's some little wooden things on the radiator cover thing as well. At Christmas, we were like, we need to get a little shed, because we changed it all round and we stopped using that awful backdrop that needed ironing. And we were like, oh, we need to get a little shed to make it sheddy. So we went everywhere trying to find a shed ornament. And I was like, oh, there'll be one for Christmas. You know, there'll be a bauble or something. Anyway, we went in Hobbycraft, didn't we? And they had these little things. Well, on the website, they looked massive, but they were actually about an inch high.
Yeah,
just pass us that one from over there, and I'll show them. So on the website, they looked like proper full house size things. This is what they actually were. That's how big they were. I was like, that's it.
Yeah, that's fine.
So then we, when we thought, oh, I wondered why they were only £2. And then we went upstairs and the bird box range that you can paint your own bird box. I was like, this looks a bit like a shed. We'll get that one. And
yeah. It always put Stevie in it.
I tried putting him in it the other day. He didn't like it.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
I tried putting him through the hole.
It's like putting him down a well.
Hey, that's what's on that next thing on that telly programme we're watching. We're watching this week. We've stopped watching Silent Witness because I got sick of it. So we're watching In Her Eyes. Behind Her Eyes, not In Her Eyes.
I'm thinking of the George Benson song.
I'm not. I'm thinking of the Peter Gabriel song, In Your Eyes.
In Your Eyes.
I don't recognise that. So anyway, let's do... Somebody, I think it was Peter Griffiths, asked for this earlier. So we're going to do this one. I'm just checking. Have I missed anything? No, Buffy. I used to love Buffy Vampire Slayer. John Atkinson's put, read the book of Behind Her Eyes. It's really good. I've actually reserved it at the library.
Yeah, no spoilers.
No spoilers.
Apparently the book is, it's quite brutal.
Is it? Yeah. I've reserved it at the library, so...
I still owe the library £20 from, I got a book from them about 11 years ago. And I've got to take it back and there's a £20 fine and I still haven't paid it. So I just don't go in there now.
There might not be the same people there, Jamie.
It's still on the system though.
Yeah.
Unless they write things off like that after a set, like with student loans. Like if you end
you
up kind of, you just don't pay it off.
Mm. Naughty Jamie. tell us if you've been watching any really good TV shows, let us know and we'll try and watch some, because that's basically all you can do. Actually, no, what we did decide last night was our listening thing. So last night we sat down and was like, oh, fancy listening to some Pink Floyd. We were like, we should do like one night a week, do like a listening night where we just like turn the lights off and light a few candles and an incense stick and have a glass of wine or something or no secco and put a classic album on the speakers and just like be like, and immerse and no phones. We're going to put our phones in the other room, aren't we? So, and no quiz books either. No puzzle books and no phones. So... and we're going to do that once a week. So I think this week we decided on Dark Side of the Moon, didn't we? And we did actually go through the process of going, could we live stream this and have a watch party with everybody? But then realised that you probably can't because of copyright. So we're just going to do it for ourselves. Okay, so we're going to do this last song just before we go. Thank you so much for tuning in. And I'm so sorry that them silly spammers at the start of it ruined it. And then I gave my password away to everybody. And... not the brightest thing to do. Anyway, that's all changed, so it's fine. So thank you for tuning in, and thank you for your patience at the start. It's very much appreciated. And thank you. Yeah, if you've popped something in the tip jar, thank you so much. It's really appreciated. And but don't feel like you've got to, because I just want you to watch it and share it and enjoy it. And yeah, so let's do this one. Okay. This is Walk on Land for Peter. And was there anyone else for this one? Don't think so. Okay.
FBI investigation. It's in a public inquiry.
So thank you so much for watching this week, and I'm sorry if it spoiled it at the start with them silly spammers, but hopefully they've all disappeared into the depths of hell and never come back to haunt us ever again. So thank you for watching. Thank you for, you know, just being here and enjoying the music with us, because we've had a lovely time. Second time round. First time round, a bit stressful, but you know. At least I didn't have a full-on meltdown. Felt like it, but I didn't. Anyway, yes, we shall see you again at 5 o'clock next week. Same time, same place. Thank you for watching. Please tell your friends. You know, it'd be great to get more and more and more people involved and commenting and stuff like that. So please share it. And I'll make an event again like I did last week, so you get notification and stuff. And, yeah, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.